to how this is working, because it's not just about blood sugar. By activating this AMPK you mentioned.
Yes.
I'm going to take it a real quick step back, because there are three main things that keep us healthy when we feel hormesis or do hormesis. You've mentioned mTOR, which is sensing amino acids.
Mm-hmm.
The ones that I work on are called sirtuins. They measure NAD and a whole bunch of stress in the body, exercise, diet. The one that we're talking about is the third one, which is called AMPK,
mm-hmm.
and it registers the amount of energy in the body, glucose, and chemical energy, which is called ATP, that mitochondria make.
Yes.
Okay. And as we get older, our body makes less and less energy,
mm-hmm.
and AMPK is the control system. And AMPK is activated by a bunch of things, which include being hungry and exercising or taking the drug metformin. So think of your glucose as doing two things. One is sticking to proteins and wrecking the proteins, and you need to turn those over by fasting or eating less regularly. But also, if you always have sugar in your body, high levels, either diabetic or just eating cake every day,
yes,
or sugar in your coffee, what you're doing is telling the body there's an abundance right now, and your AMPK defenses are not turned on. Unless you take metformin, which might bypass that.
Yeah.
But what I try to do in my life is to turn on all of those three systems, the sirtuins with boosting NAD, AMPK by taking metformin and exercising, and then the mTOR, not taking an abundance of those three amino acids I mentioned, leucine, mm-hmm. isoleucine, valine. And together, I think they work as a system. We know they talk to each other.
Yeah.
And you tweak one, the other works. We don't know what the optimal combination is.
Yeah.
That I'm experimenting on myself. So having high blood sugar is just known to accelerate aging. There's no question about it.
But why, though?
Why?
Yeah, why?
So there's a couple of reasons. There's a very simple reason and a very practical explanation, which is that the glucose that circulates in your body can be used for fuel, but it can also inadvertently get attached to your proteins.
Okay.
Yeah. And then when you've got this glucose attached to proteins, they malfunction. So that's part of this buildup. That's why you want to have some intermittent fasting,
mm-hmm.
restricted feeding, to turn over these glucuronidated proteins.
Okay.
And one of the ways to measure diabetes,
yes,
is to measure the glucose that's attached to your hemoglobin, which mm-hmm. is an abundant protein in your red blood cells.
Mm-hmm.
And doctors take that measurement. It's called HbA1c.
Mm-hmm.
That tells you how much glucose you've had in your body roughly for the last month. Because hemoglobin lasts in the body for about 3 months and it's turned over. Mm-hmm. And that number gives you a good idea of whether you've been eating badly and or you've got type 2 diabetes, which is the inability to utilize that blood sugar. That's why it's important to measure it even when you're young.
Right.
You don't want it to be going up and up and up. Mm-hmm. By the time you're type 2 diabetic, it's often too late.
Mm-hmm.
And so I've been measuring mine for the last over a decade
now. I'll bet the vast majority of the people listening to this have never done that or do it once every 3 years in some random lab test that they do, right?
Yeah.
So well
doctors
deal.
Don't pay a lot of attention to it until you're old or mm-hmm. really obese, so you're starting to show signs of type 2 diabetes, which will accelerate your aging for sure.
Mm.
So that's one problem with glucose. It'll attach to proteins and make them malfunction, and it's a sign of type 2 diabetes. By the way, the numbers are based on the percentage of your hemoglobin that has glucose attached to it, stuck to it. Anything below 5% is really great. Between 5 and 7 is pre, and then roughly, and then over 7, then you've got to be worried, and your doctor will start to treat it. And one of the drugs that's used, we'll talk about later, I think, is metformin.